Hi, my name is Lisa Klingler. I am an educational consultant for the Capital Area Intermediate Unit. I'm here today to talk about the CRA sequence. And for this video, we are going to be looking at multiplication and division of multi-digit numbers. So here we go. So again, this one we are going to do CRA and really just focusing on the C. Let me pull that down a little bit. There are other representational and abstract videos that Jared Campbell has created, so make sure you check those out. But today, like I said, we're just going to be focusing on the concrete model to model these equations. So here I have my tools that I'm going to be using. I'm going to be using some base 10 blocks to model 12 times 14. And it's important that students understand these tools and what they represent. So here I have a 100, I have a 10, and I have a 1 block. So I'm going to call this a 10 stick, call this a 1 block, and then I also have my hundreds as well. So the first I'm going to do is I'm going to set up my problem as an area model. And an area model is a nice way for students to visually see what they're multiplying and why. So the first I'm going to do is I'm going to look at my number, my first number, which is 12, and I'm going to set it up. Now here I have a nice organizer where you can see I have factor up at the top, factor on the side, and I'm going to be creating my product in the middle. You don't need to have this organizer. This can be a scaffold. This can be something that you have for students that you then take away. Because what we want is for students, if they do get stuck on this problem and they're not in the abstract yet, let's say on an assessment, they can easily draw this so that they can solve the problem easily. But here I have my organizer, and I'm going to model 12. And how I'm going to do that is I'm going to model my 1, 10, and my 2 ones right at the top of my first factor. My next factor is 14, so I know that is 1, 10, and 4 ones. 3, 4, let me move this up a little bit. Okay, and one down here. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to be multiplying my tens and my ones together. Now, I'm going to first start with my 10 and my 10. And I know that 10 times 10 is 100. So I'm going to go ahead and put my 100 block right there. And the nice thing about this is students can visually see the length and the width that equals this hundreds block. Next, I'm going to multiply my ones. So I have a 1 times a 1. Actually, let's go down the row here. So here I have a 10 and a 1. And a 10 times a 1 is always a 10. Okay, I'm going to do my next one. 10 times a 1 is always a 10. 10 times another 1. And 10 times another 1. Okay, so we're going to then work horizontally as well. So here I have a 10 times a 1, which is always equal to a 10. And again, students can really see even the shape of the 10 blocks and how they correlate. 10 times, let's move over here, 10 times a 1. And now I'm ready to do my 1 times my 1. So I have 1 times 1 is always equal to 1. Same thing here, 1 times 1. 1 times 1. 1 times 1, moving to my next one. And I'm going to finish out this row here, 1 times 1. Okay. And again, because this is an area model, we should be able to see this whole area filled with base 10 blocks in order to represent what 12 times 14 is. So because in the middle here is my product, I can then figure out based on what I have as hundreds, tens, and ones, what my answer is. So here I have 100. Write it up here. And I'm going to count my tens. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tens, which is equal to 60. And I can even count by tens if I need to. And my ones I have, I'm going to easily subitize this, I have 4 and 8. So I have 8 ones, which is equal to 8. Now I can add up 100 plus 60 plus 8, which is equal to 168. So that is how you model the problem 12 times 14 using the area model using base 10 blocks. So the next problem we're going to try is division. And here I have 72 that I'm going to represent with my base 10 blocks. And it looks like I need to put it into two groups. And we know that division is basically putting our number into groups. So this is telling me how many groups I need. What I need to figure out is how much will be in each group. So I'm going to represent my 72 with 7 tens. So I'm going to double check. That's what good mathematicians do. Double check that I have the right answer, right number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 2 ones. So what I need to do is, like I said, put this into two groups. Now for division, we are going to be working from left to right, just like we do when you're working in the abstract. So in this time, I'm going to be focusing on the tens and thinking about, can I put 7 into two groups? And the answer is yes. I can put, and I should say that evenly, can I put them into two groups evenly? So I'm going to put 3 in one group, 3 in another group, okay? And I can't split up this quite yet, so it looks like I have 3 in each group, and I'm left with a 10 and 2 ones. So in order to split up this 10, the best way to do that is to exchange. And I'm going to exchange a 10 for 10 ones. So looks like I have, let me just double check, I should have 2 plus 10 ones. So it looks like I can subitize 5, see, that's why I double check, 10, 11, 12. Now I'm going to see if I can put my 12 into two groups. And the answer is yes, I can put my 5, since I can easily see that since it looks like a 10 frame, in one group. 5 in another group, and I have 2 left over, so I can do 1 and 1. And my next question is, are my groups even? Do they have the same amount in each group? And the answer is yes. So I know now what 2 into 72 is equal to. And the answer is, it looks like I have 10, 20, 30, or 3 tens, which is equal to 30. Plus I have 5, 6 ones, which is 6. And 30 plus 6 is equal to 36. And again, ask your students how they can check that. Well, how they can check it is by putting both groups together, and the number that we should be getting would be 72. Okay. Hopefully you'll trust me that the answer is 72. So the next problem we're going to try is another division problem. And this one is going to be 3 digits here. And we have 3 groups. We're trying to make 3 groups out of 342. So the first I'm going to do is I'm going to represent my problem here, represent my number, which is 300. And 40, two. Okay? So in this case, my divisor is 3, so I need to have 3 groups. And when we have division, we are working from left to right. So I'm going to start in my hundredths place. And I'm going to say, can I break my 3 into 3 different groups and have the same amount in each group? And the answer is yes. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay, so I have my 3 groups. Now I'm going to work with my tens and say, can I break up my tens into 3 equal groups? And the answer is yes. I can put 1 10 here, 1 10 here, and 1 10 here. Now it looks like I have 1 10 left over and 2 ones. So I'm going to do the same thing that I did last time. I'm going to do some exchanging. I'm going to exchange my 10 for 10 ones. 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. And now I'm going to see if I can easily put them into groups. And let's see what I can do. I'm going to put in 4 in one group. I'm going to put in 4 in another group. And 4 in another group. Okay. Now, if I had anything left over, that would be my remainder that I could put as remainder, whatever the number is, or into a fraction. So now I'm going to see how many I have in each group, which will be my quotient. And it looks like I have 100 plus 110, which is equal to 10. And I have 4 ones, which is equal to 4. And my answer then is 100 plus 10 plus 4 is equal to 114. The last problem we're going to do together is one with a remainder. And that problem is 4 groups, 4 is my divisor. I'm putting that into 531. So I'm going to represent the 500. Let's see here. Looks like I need to grab one more 10, or one more 100. Three tens, and 1 1. And again, this time I'm going to break it up into 4 groups, since 4 is my divisor. So it looks like I'm going to start with my hundredths. I can do 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And looks like I can't really do anything else. So it looks like I'm to the point of exchanging and ungrouping my 100. So I'm going to exchange my 100 for 10 tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10. Okay, so at this point I'm ready to put them into groups. I'm going to go ahead and put 3 in one group, 3 in another group, 3, and 3. So I have 3 and I have a 10 left over and 1 1. So again, I'm going to do some exchanging. I'm going to exchange a 10 for 10 ones. Put into a nice little 10 frame there so I can easily see it. And I'm not sure how many I'm going to put in each group, so I'm just going to start putting just 2. It looks like 2 is perfect because I can't break 3 up anymore without making sure I have an even amount in each group. So this would be my 3. This would be my remainder. 3, which is not yet divided into 4. So I'm going to look at each one of my groups here and see what I have left. Looks like I have 100. I have 3 tens. And I have 2 ones, which is equal to 132. It looks like I have a remainder of 3. Or I can say 132 with 3, which is not yet divided, by 4. And that's what it looks like to put into a fraction form. So this is how you concretely represent multiplication and division with multi-digit numbers.